The opposition boycott of House sittings has entered the fourth week with no idea from opposition legislators to revisit their decision, though the House is currently on a partial recess. The Leader of Opposition, Mathias Simpuga, who addressed the press conference together with members of the opposition caucus, announced that they're not about to relent from their big cause.
The opposition still stands by its position, and from the time we departed the plenary, nobody has reached out to the opposition with a view to engendering a structured response to the issues. Save for the meeting I was involved in with the Right Honourable Deputy Speaker sometime last week, in which he communicated his attempt to try and bring these matters to bear between the opposition and the executive.
Mpoga, however, noted that their boycott has started paying off, with several government agencies resurrecting interest in cases of alleged missing persons. He noted that police and other security agencies have reopened files of victims of enforced disappearances that had been closed.
We want them to openly declare what they are doing, clearly, and how they are doing it, because complaints about the missing persons were raised with the police many months ago, years actually, and they were not moved. They should explain to the country what has changed now that is prompting them to move.
The Leader of Opposition reiterated the six-point demand on human rights abuses, including the 18 missing persons, targeting and victimizing Muslims, detention without trial, violation of human rights in fishing communities, shrinking civic space, and trying of civilians in the court martial.
Are yet to be responded to, and they constituted the reasons for our decision to let matters of plenary be what they are.
On their menu, the opposition has added the matter of Balalo that is drawing tensions in northern Uganda. They contend that the executive order by President Yoweri Museveni has elements of irregularity that have to be addressed before enforcing it.
By General Museveni, that those who have land should do fence it off is illegal, irregular, and has no legal space.
There is a court ruling recently which has said clearly that nobody can buy customary land. So we are surprised that the president himself tells the Balalo to go and fence the customary land.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.